Hey, it's Monday and it's 2020. So that means another week working from home, I guess. But we're getting used to it now, aren't we? I want to use this video, a couple of minutes, to talk about some of the positive aspects of remote work. Now, for me, the way a work week would usually start, I'm a public speaker, so that meant an alarm early, I mean really early in the morning to get to the airport before rush hour. I used to fly more than a pilot. The way you know that is they send you this secret level above frequent flyer card. We are the ones with these cool black luggage tags. This is the sign of pleasure and guilt. Well, I guess I won't be getting these much longer. Now, these days, a Monday morning typically starts with an hour of trail running or so, and then on to a long, slow breakfast. So for someone like me, cutting away that chunk, all that travel, means oceans of time for whatever I want. And of course, this is good. This is good for my health, for my carbon footprint, many reasons. Then after breakfast, I'm usually here in my office. Or these days, we refer to it as the home studio. There are cameras and cables and tech stuff everywhere, so I can't even find my desk anymore. But this is where I work. I do recordings, meetings, presentations, live streams. It's amazing when you think about it. I mean, I can broadcast live from home to an unlimited number of people anywhere in the world. That was just impossible. 10, 15 years ago, to do something like this, you needed a broadcasting studio, satellite equipment, hundreds of thousands of dollars in a budget. It's kind of funny because last year, if you follow me, you know that 1 year ago, that's 1 year BC, as we say, I recorded this. A job is only a what. What do I do? And more importantly, what do I do to get paid? My answer to that is that I'm a speaker. I stand in front of people and I talk to bring food for thought, to challenge them and inspire them. That's what I do for money. But as you know, you need to start from the opposite direction. You need to start with a why. If you're not familiar with this, check out the link down below and listen to Simon Sinek in his world famous speech about how to start with why and why that is important to you. Or read his book. My why is to help people embrace change. And then how I do that and what I get paid to do have changed many times throughout my life and career and will continue to change, just like any other job. Maybe I can meet more people like you now here online, and then I don't need to travel as much anymore. And maybe in the future I will be referred to as a YouTuber rather than a speaker. Who knows?
Here we are. And with all that money now pouring into streaming companies, we can expect these services, all the platforms, to become much better in the coming years. I fully expect the option for virtual reality meetings in just 2 years' time, so that we can all have the experience of being together in the same physical space, even though we're not. And of course, this will set a new standard. I mean, sure, we are social animals, so we will meet again. I even believe the business conferences and the whole meeting industry will set new record highs by the end of next year. Think of it, 2 years of social distancing, that means that everyone will try to grab the opportunity as soon as possible to host the best social gathering. But that's also a new standard. Our expectations and our demands for in real life meetings means the bar is up here. You don't ask me to do it old style, like I told you, the alarm at 5 in the morning and the hassle and the cost of traveling and staying away from home, from family, for something we could have done in the virtual world just as well. That's just not going to be acceptable anymore. The days of traveling to hear someone just read a PowerPoint are finally over. Great events, however, great experiences created to connect, social gatherings that makes
everything we do online easier just because we already connected, so we know each other. These events, these are the ones we will all look forward to, just like a cool vacation plan or something like this. That will be the new standard. 21st century events, that will be part of the reason we work so hard. Another way of thinking about this trend, remote work, is to think about what it might mean for us in the long term, society. How will this impact society? And I don't mean like real estate prices when corporate offices can be smaller or any other like industry trend. I mean, for real, how do we live our lives today and how will that change? Think of transformation, like from farmers to industrial workers. If we are in this transformation now from office workers to out of office workers, wouldn't that mean that you can now climb that career ladder by spending a lot of time somewhere else? You don't necessarily need to be in the office. Maybe this is a great opportunity for us to erase gender imbalance. The fact that no one now have to choose between work at home or away from home. When you think of it, still today in 2020, so many women had to make that choice between a professional life and a family life. But if we can all work from home and managers instead have to start to learn how to measure employees by results and contributions rather than from how many hours they spend in the office, then maybe no one have to make that choice anymore. Well, like always, the future is not to be predicted, it is to be created. These are just opportunities. I mentioned two new opportunities, a booming event industry for the ones who create awesome social gatherings aimed at connection. And a new manual for managers to learn how to evaluate employees who aren't in the office. And someone out there right now will spot these opportunities and act to create a future success story. It's Monday and it's 2020. I'll see you in the future. And hey, if you want more videos, hit that like button and make sure to subscribe.